And this loop has been rendered using World Wide Web. World Wide Web is a library which helps us to create this loop. Now, we have loaded some basic layers.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Ishita Agrawal from CSEA second year. So the topic of our project is AIDA, which stands for Astronomical Images and Datasets Analysis Toolkit. So AIDA is a tool that helps in visualizing the data in a very interactive manner. With AIDA, we can break data to convenient size to focus on a particular region or to look at a bigger picture altogether. We have rendered a globe using World Wide Web to get a vivid display and make it easy for the users to study the data and at the same time making it very interactive. We have used data sets from different sources such as NASA NEO, MODIS, Landsat and USGS. Apart from this, AIDA has an earthquake visualizer that takes data from the USGS. Now what can we do using AIDA? So AIDA basically helps us study data for different regions of the globe. The data related to land surface temperature or nitrogen dioxide, forest fire population, etc. can be studied in a very interactive manner using AIDA. Now, next, this is a picture of how our website looks like. Now, next is how AIDA works. So AIDA takes in WMS layers and data from NASA Earth Observations, MODIS, Landsat and displays it using World Wide Web. AIDA has an earthquake visualizer that shows the earthquake epicenters around the world within the query period given by user. It takes data from the USGS and creates a layer that can be modified by the users to show the epicenters. Now, how we have made AIDA? So firstly, we have designed the front end, then we have coded it using HTML and CSS, then we have created the backend using Flask and Python. Then we have rendered data from the NEO, MODIS, Landsat and USGS and dynamically added the layers to the World Wide Globe. Then we have tested the site and finally deployed it using Heroku. Now next, for front end, we have used HTML, CSS, JavaScript. And the data and resources have been taken from the space agencies like NEO, USGS, that stands for United States Geological Survey, MODIS, Landsat, and World Wide Web. And then for backend, we have used Python and Flask framework. Then for earthquake visualizer, we have used Plotly.js. It's a graphing library. Then for styling, along with CSS, we have used Bootstrap templates. Then for seamless loading of the World Wide Globe, we have used jQuery, and finally we have deployed it using Heroku. Now I would request Devanjana to discuss about the frameworks that we have used.
Thank you, Ishita. So as mentioned earlier, we have seen that the globe has been rendered using World Wide Web. So what is it actually? The World Wide Web JS is a fork of the popular Web Worldwide library from NASA. And this work provides a release channel for builds based on the latest fixes and features from Web Worldwide's develop branch, plus several cherry-picked enhancements from the Worldwide community. And it also supports development of several personal projects like the Worldwide Explorer, the wildfire management, and many other things. Now, there are many enhancements as well. For example, a template for creating geo-browser web apps, then keyboard navigation controls for the globe. Now, another thing I would like to discuss is what is Flask. So Flask is basically a microwave framework which is written in Python. Now, the reason it is classified as a micro framework is because it does not require particular tools or libraries. It has no database abstraction layer or form validation or any other components where pre-existing third-party libraries provide common functions. Now, the last thing I would like to discuss is what is CI/CD. Now, in software engineering, CI/CD is it refers to the combined practices of continuous integration and either continuous delivery or continuous deployment. And it also bridges the gaps between development and operation activities and teams by enforcing automation in building, testing, and deployment of applications. So now let's have a look at our website. which Orkoprobo will show you.
Let's move on to the website. This is our homepage for AIDA. We rendered this using NASA APOD API, which is Astronomical Picture of the Day API. So this screen refreshes every day with the new info. This is just for fun. We added this because we were a bit bored while coding this. And we did this within 2 days time because it was prepared for the NASA Space Apps Hackathon. So we had some amount of time crunch, so we could only display some of the features in this site. So let's head to NEO or NASA Earth Observation site. Here we have the different layers that load onto this globe, and this globe has been rendered using World Wide Web. World Wide Web is a library which helps us to create this globe. Now we have loaded some basic layers, or the mostly used layers as classified by NASA themselves. So here we have the globe, and this globe not only have a simple globe structure for visualizing the data sets, but there are different projections available as well. We will shortly see how it's done. So it not only provides you with a blank globe, but also with the description about the dataset, a very small and interactive description about it. So let's go on to the Earthquake Visualizer, where we have integrated all the features that are available for AIDA. So this is the Earthquake Visualizer page. And these are the various epicenters of the earthquakes around the world. So we split up the data sets using this globe format, but if anyone wants the entire data set in one roof, then he or she can go up to the globe options and can switch the visualization to equirectangular, and you get the classic world map visualization of the entire earthquake data sets. Not only that, you can switch on to different other imaging or projection images, like the North Polar projection, which is a classic North Polar projection, or you can switch on to South Polar projections depending upon your requirement. We go back to the 3D projection, and sometimes the globe just gets a bit fuzzy. So using the controls, you can rotate it back to your position or the initial position or any position where you want. You can zoom in with the mouse scroll, and it's basically more of like a Google Earth. So we also have different layers like ping aerial with labels. Now this aerial label adds on the location details about the various earthquake centers, and also you can zoom in to find out more information about different locations. And now the primary thing about the earthquake visualizer is you want to query the earthquake data set that we have taken from USGS, and you want to visualize it. So by default, here we have the search options. By default, we give the data set for 10 days window, but it can be customized. We can customize the magnitude range, like by default it is 4. We can set it down to 0, so we will get more amount of earthquakes. More amount of epicenters loaded onto the layer. And we can also arrange it by magnitude. By default it's arranged by time, but we can arrange it by magnitude. The layer will take some time to refresh. And yeah, there we go. You can see that it is arranged by magnitude. And the most impactful earthquake was around here, near the Bering Sea. So if you want to look at it, we have to traverse around the globe, which might be a bit confusing and can be a bit tedious. So we also have a gist prepared for you to visualize. So here we have the magnitude distribution which is a frequency versus magnitude histogram, and it can be saved using this download as a .png option. We also provide depth, I mean the frequency versus depth analysis for the earthquake, and also time series data for showing the number of earthquakes versus the time, and each of these plots can be saved. We also have a summary, search summary, which basically gives you the number of earthquakes, start date, end date. By default it gives a 10-day window gap, and minimum magnitude is zero because we had set it to zero as here, and maximum magnitude is 10 because we had set it to 10, and minimum depth is obviously zero and maximum depth too. So that's all from our side.
Orkrabava Chakraborty, myself Devanjana Vashak, Ishita Agarwal, and our respected sir Shomnath Roy Chaudhary. And this is the project that we made addressing one of the challenges in the NASA Space App Challenge, Home Planet at Your Fingertips. The name of our project is ADA. And here we have included all the details, the summary, how we address this challenge, then some pictures and how we developed this project, the tech stack used over here. The project demo is also given and the code is given in Jitter. And we have also shown all the data sources that we have used. So that's it. Thank you.
Project is your the excellent presentation, excellent skin, but you have to keep on the team. And right now, the whole world is going for the COVID-19. And this is